Hello guys, and welcome back to another Final Fantasy VII Ever Crisis video. Today's video, we actually have a huge update, which I need to go ahead and let you know about. So, let's talk about... Well, we have our day of 7th gift, don't forget about that. You're getting 1k of blue crystals. We'll start up the 7th of each month, which I believe, well, I think it could be tomorrow, today. But the distribution period, it's until March the 10th, so just keep that in mind. We have a new campaign. It's called the Knights of Judgment Project Zero Remnant. So as for today's date, we actually have the campaign. During the campaign, rewards will be distributed as an epilogue will be released in accordance with the number of times of the target quests are cleared for players worldwide. So as you can see, rewards in accordance to the number of clears, stamina tonic, blue crystals, and epilogue release, and pretty much I think that's it. We'll check about this more on. I know that there's a lot more of the event that we have, which is the next one. So it's, well, you get exclusive items for participating in the event. You get a luxurious reward, which is Chariot Wheel, which that one provides what Terra Surge and boosts magic attack. And as you can see, I think that we know the weaknesses of the Chariot Wheel, which is water and ice, which I believe I have Cloud, so Cloud is very good with that. And Ice, I think I have, unless if we have Sephiroth's weapon, which is the Frostblade, I could have combined Lucia and Sephiroth besides of that, but I have to check the build of my team. But yeah, pretty much we got the banners, which we're going to talk about later on, which I think is going to be the last. We got the half anniversary campaign, which, as you can see, half anniversary, day free limit of 10 draws up to 280 draws, which is 28 days, which I think it's going to be between all of month of March and the beginning of April. Plus, every Wednesday, 5-star appearance rate is double, which today is Wednesday, so I believe, if I want to pull right now, the appearance of a 5-star weapon, it's double. So we have our chances there. We also have our half anniversary login bonus. Log in during the period to get the wallpaper a saber style and a total of blue crystals of 3k. You also log in for 4 days and you get a total of mithril ore per 70, which this is a very, very good opportunity to increase the level of your weapons to level 80 to level 90, which is a very good success. And complete the, you know, pretty much the things like log in every Wednesday to get a total of blue crystals, which is 4.9k, which is very good. And during the period, Cloud and Glenn's gain XP, it's increased by 200. Cloud, I know that many people already have Cloud level 70. He's the main character, so it makes sense that Cloud is the first one that you need to increase to level 70. And for people who haven't done that, you guys are at... Nah, I'm just kidding. But, well, to get the idea, Cloud and Glenn are increased by level 200%, so you're good. And during the period, for players who are under level 30, all characters gain is increased by 400%, which is a very huge update for all the people who want to level up, of course, under level 30. So this is going to be for newcomers or for people who want to return to the game. And you also have all volume 1 to volume 3 draws to get 3 or 5 star weapons for free guarantee. For free guarantee, I need to go ahead and check that out. Again, to get 3 or more 5 star weapons means that if you pull for 1, you guarantee 1 star. Second pull, you get another 5 star. Third pull, you get another 5 star weapon, which you get 3. And if you're lucky, you can get more. Again, this is a misinterpretation from the first time that they gave us this banner. They thought that in the first pool you get 3 or more 5-star weapons. But it was a mistranslation or misunderstanding for people. So, just to clear that out. And, well, I don't want to talk about this one because I know that this is for whalers. And I told you guys, many of Square Enix games, mobile games, are end to finish. So, don't do that. Believe me, I haven't put any single, well, except for the banner, except for that wallpaper, which is the season pass, that was the only time that I put money on it because I really, really love the wallpaper of all the waifus. So, okay, we have that. And we have a special draw. This is giving us an indication that half anniversary, only today, 5-star appearance rate double. So you may want to do that right now. Guys, I know. And all of you are gonna say to me, shut the hell up.
Don't forget your wish list. That's all I'm gonna say.
So I want Tifa, Yuffie. I already have two for Yuffie. I don't need another one for Yuffie. What am my next one? I already completed this one, so I don't need that. Oh yeah, I forgot the umbrella. I need the umbrella for Aerith. Red 13. Do I need something for Zack? Maybe this one? Is there anything for Sephiroth that I want to choose? No, I think not. I think this is going to be my next one. What was my previous one? Oh! It was Lucia's. So let me change that up. And checking about this kind of star thing, I believe we're getting a good, cool banner right now. But let me just change quickly Lucia's wish list. Wait a second. Let me confirm. Oh yeah, it was the confirm thing. I'm getting sick again, so maybe you're gonna hear me a bit bad. Oh wait. The first one, what was it? Oh, it was Tifa, right? It was Tifa. I remember. It was this one. Well, yeah, Zack needs it. Zack really needs that. Let me change Lucia to this one. Yeah, that's it. So let's go ahead and talk about the banner. So as you can see, we have weapons for Cloud and Glenn. So this one first is the Stream Saber. As you can see, deals 500% physical ice damage, which is for a single enemy. Boost physical attack for all allies, which is very good. Boost ice potency. Yeah, I don't want people ranting just because I say potential or potency, so I'll say potency there. Physical and sigil boost, which is very good. And the skin, physical attack and Frostblade Arcanum. I don't like this. I really don't like the boost physical attack for 5 points. Because they usually put 10 and 10. But I always like the skins. If you really like the skin for Cloud, to be honest, it's very stunning. It's very cool. I'm not gonna lie. It's a very, very cool skin. If you want to get the skin because you want to see your Cloud Y, go ahead and do it. I will go for it if I had the sufficient crystals. I don't have any blue crystals anymore. And for Glenn, the cape, man. The cape. Even so that Glenn is not a very, you know, I don't think that many people play Glenn so often. This skin is cool. Oh, man. If I had blue crystals for that, not gonna waste money on that. So for this one, we got Flooding Stream, deals 500 physical water damage for a single enemy. This one boosts physical allies, physical attack for all allies, and boosts water potential. Potency, I know, takes me a lot of time to say potency, but I know that people are going to rant. Physical, and sigil boost, which were good. And this one has boost physical and water blade arcanum, which, again, I don't like it, but if you like the skin, go for it. I always pull because I love skins. That's all I want. That's why I went poor to this banner. And we have a new stem gear card. I forgot. We have a new stem gear card. So I remember that in the... I don't know if it's in the notice. Let me go ahead and check that out. About the chocobos. I think it's under this one. But it's not this one. It should be over this one. So there you go. Additional effects on the draw stamp cards. As featured that it's indicated, the expected number of stamps will be present will be added to the stamp card. If you get a normal chocobo, you get low expected number of stamps. If you get red chocobo, medium expected number of stamps. Black chocobo, high expected number of stamps. Chocobo and Kate said, very high expected number of stamps. Please note that these effects only appear to the number of stamps present on the stamp card and do not affect the appearance expected rate on the draw. There's no change to the odds to the number of stamps present on the stamp card, and this will be applied to draws with stamp cards from March 6th onwards. So this is a new update for the Chocobos. So I don't know how it works. If I go directly to the stamp card, maybe I can understand. So it says reach the 8 square on page 2 for a total 3 or more weapons guarantee. Which I believe that if you choose this one, maybe you can get a gland, you can choose one. So this is a new update. This is really cool. Like the Tifa banner that we had on the crossover event, when you actually have two Tifa's weapons, because obviously if you want to pull for a banner, you want to go specifically for the weapon, and you're not able to get the weapon because of the odds. Now you're able to pull more, and you'll be guaranteed to get the weapon that you want. Well, in this case, we got Glenn and Cloud, but you can choose, like, I don't know, I want Cloud Stream Saber, and then I first one Cloud Steam Saber, then you're actually good to go. And you'll have not only one, you get an Overboost 2, which it's more than enough that you can get the wallpaper for the weapon and the skin. So you're actually good to that. That's why I ended up very poor on the previous banner, because I really, really love Red 13's shiny or a different variant. I know it's just red to black, but seeing Red 13 in the black, it's absolutely amazing and it's badass. That's why I ended up being poor on that banner. It's very, very cool. And this limit break, I don't know, man. I really, really want to try this banner out just to see what you can get, though. And I don't have blue crystals. Yeah, there you go. And I'm pretty sure that we have a campaign for that. Do we? Oh, it's the Bahamut and the Shiva. Oh, have anniversary. Clear solo battle in event 550 times. You get two. No, we don't have anything else. Okay, so I don't see anything. I can pull for this banner twice. Or maybe not. The thing here is that I don't like those weapons. But those, you know, you get the point, right? Like, you see those blue draws and you get this. Does that have to do anything about the half anniversary, you think, though? I don't know. But any of all, we got our first volume. You get this for free. You get this for free. So I think I'm going to do by draws. So let's go ahead and just make a quick... I don't know if they've done another... We have a lot of updates that we need to take care of. I'm pretty sure about that. Now, if I go to the Chocobos, I know that there was an update for the Chocobos, because I think that they added more areas. And if I go to the Chocobo Expeditions, let me check if I'm wrong. Maybe I'm wrong. Let me go ahead and check that. So if I make Expedition, yeah, they added more. So they added more in the Chocobo situation. Well, why not? Why not? So we have... Oh, okay, okay. We can depart. No. Yeah, I knew for a fact that we were going to have more expedition areas. So this is just cool. So let me go ahead and do expedition here. So we already have this one. Let me go to this one. It's the same Chocobo. We don't have any problems with that. And this one also, we can just put an expedition here. And well, you know, you have more treasures. If you have the Chocobo booster like me, I'm pretty sure that you will finish this in no time. 5% of the area Midgard, 10%, 55, 25%. Like, this is very easy. And if you complete it right now, well, you have a limit, of course. You can only do 99 Chocobo boosters. So that's your daily limit. So you don't have to do that so often. But all of them are CEC Plus and everything, so I'm pretty sure that you are able to get it. I'm not sure that in the exchange you have more Chocobos. If there's anyone that has, like, I don't know, a B Plus or something like that, I don't know about that one. No, I don't think so. And you also have more missions there. Like, yeah, oh, explore 50%. You have a B one. Explore 50% of the Midgard. Oh my goodness. Guys, I may want to go ahead and pause the video and see if I can get lucky or not. Let me go ahead and check that out. It's just because for me to not waste your time. Okay, I'm back again. Unfortunately, I was not able to get Midgard 5. I did unlock it, But at least I collect the, you know, the expeditions, and you're also able to get more blue crystals. This one is very important. Explore 50% of the area of Midgard 5, and obviously it's a B1. So for people who haven't wasted any chocobo medals, and you get to get a B chocobo, then you're actually very good to get a higher chocobo, because those chocobos that we have are only C+. Those are the only chocobos that we're able to get, though. And by the way, we have a new battle pass or treasure hunt, whatever. Just remember that when you go to the fifth one, you're guaranteed to get a 5-star weapon, just in case people want to have it. For me, honestly, I don't want to pull it. Don't want to play anymore or waste any more about that one. I'll just simply go ahead and go directly. This is just the main reason why I purchased the battle pass. It was just because of this wallpaper. When you're actually going to get like a wallpaper, all of the current waifus of Final Fantasy, even so that Lucia is a new one, but hey, she's a waifu still. Well, we got the anniversary crystal boost, which I don't consider to be good. And yeah, just do your daily stuff, you know? You don't want to miss all your daily stuff because you want to complete all your missions. I always do this, even so, because Gil is something that you can get very easy. And, well, I'm out of words. So I just want to do the recap and see if I can make any kind of pulls. So let's get on to that. So I remember the recap. We got the event, which we need to check the event. That is the last thing that I want to check about. If we go to the events, if you have one more time to do this, complete it, guys. You get a lot of materials here from there. This is very, very amazing to get, so just complete it your last time. Knights of Judgment, which I mentioned, you need to get characters, which... pretty much we got obtained 200 golden wheels. Oh wait, you already get the wallpapers right now? Well, that's cool. 2,000 golden wheels. At least you don't have to attempt to do the wallpaper thing. You got the chariot wheel. We got a 5-star guarantee draw ticket. 10 times weapon guarantee draw ticket. Then the draw normal draw tickets. Then you got mithril ores. In case if you want Yuffie specific weapon. Yuffie memory, sack memory. And all the normal stuff that you can get. Pretty much it's just simple and easy. Obviously, you want to go directly to the weapons, which is Yuffie's one. You want to get the 5-star guarantee draw ticket, which it costs 1k, it's a lot. Then 10 of them, which is 3k. Then 10 of them, which is 300. Yeah, 300. It's not... yeah, it is 300, right? Or 3,000? No, I think it's just 300. Yeah, it's 30. It's not so much. So, one more thing that we need to talk about is going to be Yuffie's weapon. So, as you can see, you have 210 magic water damage, range for all enemies, boosts his magic attack, and boosts his water potency. Then you got attack boost, magic attack boost, which is a very good weapon. So you want to go directly to Yuffie's weapon. It's a story, as you can see. Complete all the stories here. You may want to actually get the 9k because I want to do 3 draws for that banner. Or maybe not. Maybe no. I'm not very interested in that banner. You guys can tell me, like, what do you actually got from the banners? Because I really want to save for that banner. So, that. You get the anniversary. You get our Cloud and Glenn's weapon banner, which are amazing. One is for water. One is for ice. I think ice is for Cloud. Water is for Glenn. One is for ice potency. The other one is water potency. And, of course, every single day, don't forget to do your 10 free draws. And for this one as well. So, and only today, we got a 5-star appearance rate double. Let's make our bets at least 2. Give me 2. I'm very happy with 2. I'm very, very happy with 2. Nothing else. Nothing more. Just give me 2. 2, 1, 2. I'm happy. I'm very happy with that. And both were from Sephiroth. It was Sephiroth, right? This is Sephiroth? Yeah. This one is the Northern Lights. And the other one is Ainobi parts. Even though that I don't use those weapons, I say give me 2 golden weapons. You did it. Thank you so much. For this one, I know that I'm going to get 1. I don't want to be greedy, but can we get at least 2 again? 2 again? I'm not asking so much. Well, we got the guaranteed one. I don't mind. And what was that? Well, it's okay. At least it's free. And I'm not wasting any money for that. or any blue crystals. The new stamp card gear, I really don't want to. I really don't want to waste on this banner. Even so that the skins are right, I don't like the weapons. So, if you want to pull for that banner, go ahead, be my guest. Tell me what do you think about this banner, if you really like it or not. The boost physical attack and all allies is very good, but I don't want to pull for that because even so that the skin of Cloud is very amazing and the one for Glenn also is amazing, I don't want to pull for this banner, really, really, really. And guys, I forgot to do this video, but we previously had a bait banner. I should have told you that stay away from that banner because you get any single weapon from the wish list, but it's something that you can do in the normal banners. If you got bait, sorry that I didn't advise, but I did told that in a previous video on December when we got our first bait banner. So if you got to the bait banner, this is why you're wasting your money or why you need to use your wallet. Because if you already have like a lot of blue crystals like I had from the... from the crossover event, then you already was your blue crystals in a bait banner that you didn't need it to pull. So that's all I can say, guys. So good luck with this pulls, and if you're enjoying the new update, then go ahead. Chocobo is very good. The stamps is kind of cool, but I think I'm gonna do that once that I once that I get a banner that it interests me the most. But this, because this one, I don't like it. So, and again, don't forget to do this every single day. We're going to have another two more times of the other banner, which is a guaranteed 5-star. And just forget about this banner. It's a bait one. And this, well, 300 red crystals doesn't hurt. But again, it involves money. And, you know, pretty much you don't want to invest money in a game that later on is going to be bye-bye. Gone. So that's all. I don't have anything else to say. One more thing that I forgot to tell, if you don't have Cloud or Glenn to level 70, this is your chance because you get 200% of extra XP for both of those characters. So, nothing else, nothing more. I think I'm finished. See you guys later. Oh, this is in respect about Final Fantasy VII Rebirth. I'm gonna take a lot of my time, so don't expect me to upload every single thing of Rebirth because I am enjoying the game. I have 8 hours of gameplay and I'm still in the calm place. So I'm going to take my time. If you guys want to see all the whole story, go ahead. I'm not even spoiling myself. I did got a major spoiler, but I'm not going to tell that in public. So just avoid Facebook, avoid YouTube as far as you can. If you're playing Final Fantasy VII Rebirth, if you want to see it with me with the videos, there's going to be a time that I'm going to live stream it so we can enjoy a bit of our times, maybe speak again. I really miss the days that I really like to speak with my public when I had Kingdom Hearts Unicross on the time. So maybe I'm going to do a live stream on Final Fantasy VII in the future. But I'm going to take my time to upload the videos, to upload the gameplay, because I'm really enjoying the game. So that's all. That's the last thing I'm going to talk about. So guys, we'll see y'all later. May your hearts be your guiding key. And I'll see you into the next video. Honkai, Genshin, Rebirth, anything. So I'll see you guys later. And good luck with your pulls. Goodbye.